The Barbary lion was a Panthera leo population in North Africa that is regionally extinct. This population occurred in Barbary coastal regions of Maghreb from the Atlas Mountains to Egypt and was eradicated following the spread of firearms and bounties for shooting lions. A comprehensive review of hunting and sighting records revealed that small groups of lions may have survived in Algeria until the early 1960s, and in Morocco until the mid-1960s. Until 2017, the Barbary lion was considered a distinct lion subspecies. Results of morphological and genetic analyses of lion samples from North Africa published in 2008 showed that the Barbary lion does not differ significantly from lion samples collected in west and northern parts of Central Africa. It falls into the same phylogeographic group as the Asiatic lion, and is also closely related to lion populations in West Africa. The Barbary lion was also called North African lion, Berber lion, Atlas lion, and Egyptian lion. Barbary lion zoological specimens range in color from light to dark tawny. Male lion skins had short manes, light manes, dark manes, or long manes. Head-to-tail length of stuffed males in zoological collections varies from 2.35 to 2.8 meters, 7 feet 8 and a half in to 9 feet 2 in, and of females around 2.5 meters, 8 feet 2 in. Skull size varied from 30.85 to 37.23 centimeters, 12 and 5/32 to 14 and 21/32 in. Some manes extended over the shoulder and under the belly to the elbows. The mane hair was 8 to 22 centimeters, 3 to 8 and a half in long. In 19th century hunter accounts, the Barbary lion was claimed to be the largest lion, with a weight of wild males ranging from 270 to 300 kilograms, 600 to 660 pounds. Yet the accuracy of such data measured in the field is questionable. Captive Barbary lions were much smaller but kept under such poor conditions that they might not have attained their full potential size and weight. The color and size of lions' manes was long thought to be a sufficiently distinct morphological characteristic to accord a subspecific status to lion populations. Mane development varies with age and between individuals from different regions, and is therefore not a sufficient characteristic for subspecific identification. The size of manes is not regarded as evidence for Barbary lions' ancestry. Instead, results of mitochondrial DNA research support the genetic distinctness of Barbary lions in a unique haplotype found in museum specimens that is thought to be of Barbary lion descent. The presence of this haplotype is considered a reliable molecular marker to identify captive Barbary lions. Barbary lions may have developed long-haired manes because of lower temperatures in the Atlas Mountains than in other African regions, particularly in winter. Results of a long-term study on lions in Serengeti National Park indicate that ambient temperature, nutrition and the level of testosterone influence the color and size of lion manes. Felis leo was the scientific name proposed by Carl Linnaeus in 1758 for a lion-type specimen from Constantine, Algeria. Following Linnaeus's description, several lion zoological specimens from North Africa were described and proposed as subspecies in the 19th century. While the historical Barbary lion was morphologically distinct, its genetic uniqueness remained questionable. In a comprehensive study about the evolution of lions in 2008, 357 samples of wild and captive lions from Africa and India were examined. Results showed that four captive lions from Morocco did not exhibit any unique genetic characteristic but shared mitochondrial haplotypes with lion samples from West and Central Africa. They were all part of a major mtDNA grouping that also included Asiatic lion samples. Results provided evidence for the hypothesis that this group developed in East Africa, and about 118,000 years ago traveled north and west in the first wave of lion expansion. It broke up within Africa, and later in West Asia. Lions in Africa probably constitute a single population that interbred during several waves of migration since the late Pleistocene. Historical accounts indicate that in Egypt lions occurred in the Sinai Peninsula, along the Nile, in the eastern and western deserts, in the region of Wadi El Natron and along the maritime coast of the Mediterranean. In the 14th century BC, Thutmose IV hunted lions in the hills near Memphis. In Morocco, the last recorded shooting of a wild Barbary lion took place in 1942 near Tizanitichka in the Atlas Mountains. In the early 20th century, when Barbary lions were not common anymore, they were sighted in pairs or in small family groups comprising a male and female lion with one or two cubs. Between 1839 and 1942, sightings of wild lions involved solitary animals, pairs and family units. Analysis of these sightings indicate that lions retained living in prides even when under increasing persecution, particularly in the eastern Maghreb. The size of prides was likely similar to prides living in sub-Saharan habitats, whereas the density of the Barbary lion population is considered to have been lower than in moister habitats. When Barbary stags and gazelles became scarce in the Atlas Mountains, lions preyed on herds of livestock that were rather carefully tended. They also preyed on wild boar and red deer. Sympatric predators in this area included the African leopard and Atlas bear. The lions kept in the menagerie at the Tower of London in the Middle Ages were Barbary lions. The lion appeared frequently in early Egyptian art and literature. Statues and statuettes of lions found at Hierakonpolis and Koptos in Upper Egypt date to the early dynastic period. The early Egyptian deity Mehit was depicted with a lion head. In ancient Egypt, the lion-headed deity Sekhmet was venerated as protector of the country. She represented destructive power, but was also regarded as protector against famine and disease. Barbary lion in Colosseum of Rome. In Roman North Africa, lions were regularly captured by experienced hunters for venatio spectacles and amphitheaters. Morocco national football team is called Atlas Lions, and the supporters are usually seen wearing t-shirts with a lion's face or wearing a lion suit.